welcome back to the Processing Playground. I've been doing them from the dog bed. I don't know why, it just feels really comfortable here. And this one is about, and it's so interesting being with my dog. I have two dogs. Dogs, we all know from, you know, most of us have dogs or been around them, how loyal and open and how unconditional their love is. And as humans, we don't always do that with each other. We create conditions. And why do we create conditions? Because there's something that we want from the other person that we just don't know how to get from ourselves. So what does that create? Self-centeredness. And it's very different than being centered in yourself, right? And so as human beings walking this planet and trying to figure things out and getting hurt along the way or not getting certain ego needs met as we were growing up or be conditioned to think our worth is outside of us, which happens, we can become very egocentric and it can create this sense of entitlement. I hear that a lot lately. It's like people are so entitled. And really underneath the entitlement is that we start to see the world very myopically and it's all about me and I can only see this way. And then we get really stuck and we're not only hurting other people, we're really hurting ourselves. And underneath that entitlement, we have to drop the titles and the needs for achievement and really get tuned in to what is triggering that, what's creating the hurt. And it's usually a fear that we're not enough. So if we pull the curtain back and the layers back and really get to the center, there's usually something very tender. And that tenderness is our vulnerability. And that vulnerability, we've been told otherwise, is actually our power. Because we're willing to see ourselves in all of our realness and our rawness. And then we're also allowing other people to see that part. And then they can truly love us for who we truly are, not for who we think we need to be. Easier said than done, because there's a lot of messages in so many different areas of our culture and our upbringing and religion and that is saying something else. So part of our path, you know, through yoga, through asana, through meditation, whatever that is, through therapy, coaching, is to make our way back to being centered in the seat of our soul rather than being self-centered. So if you find yourself, which we all do, I think, at times, wanting to fix or control or get something from another person or just see it from our very narrow perspective, it's an opportunity to kind of rein ourselves back and go, ooh, how can I open up my vision to see from other perspectives? Oftentimes it means we have to go in and see what we want and feel what it is that we need. And we're trying so hard to get out in the external world. And we bring our joy back. We bring our power back because we're sitting in the seat of the center of who we are and not being self-centered. So it is a shift from ego and sort of narcissism, which happens, and back into, right, the flip, back into, I have this, I sit in my truth, I take ownership. And it really is about that accountability and being fully embodied. And that's what makes life so playful and so much fun because we don't get rigid or stuck. So if you find yourself at times being centered, or not centered, I should say, you're human and be compassionate. And therefore you'll be more compassionate with others. And therefore we learn to be more vulnerable and open and really learn how to communicate soul to soul, heart to heart, and see beyond our narrow myopic vision and open up to really understanding different perspectives, different cultures, different ways of thinking. And that's true communication, and that's joy, and that's liberation. So I hope you find this helpful, and thank you for joining me here on the Processing Playground.